L405 disc bulge or L5S1 disc bulge and neuroforaminal stenosis. Why is neuroforaminal stenosis such a problem, especially when there's also an accompanying disc bulge? Well, take a look at this. This is what a normal foraminal stenosis looks like. See that nerve is coming out of that yellow wire, that opening right there? That's the neural foramen, and that nerve is not being compressed, okay? Now, when there is arthritis, degenerative disease, osteophytes, bone spurs, disc bulges, disc injuries that are protruding into that neuroforaminal stenosis right there. See that one? See the difference? That's being compressed by that nerve. That will compress that nerve and cause either local pain or also referring radiating pain wherever that nerve goes to. If you look over here, that nerve over here, the L4 nerve here, L5 nerve, feeds into the sciatic nerve, goes right away down to the thigh and the calf, right down into the foot. And that's why it causes massive pain into the leg.